A remarkable feature of the cattle dung, which is utilized by the beetles, is the dung's highly supportive nature toward not just any mycological life, but instead, cattle dung is particularly known for producing a psychoactive, hallucinogenic, psilocybin cubensis species. Mushroom species containing psilocybin are said to occur on all continents throughout the globe, including areas of New Guinea, Africa, Colombia, Mexico, Peru, Argentina, Venezuela, and others. Studies of the psilocybin mushroom in both southern Mexico and Houston have shown P. cubensis to thrive, quote, exclusively in pastures on decomposing cow dung or found on cow dung and rice hull compost in fields that support cattle, unquote. Rice hull can be expected to show mycological growth, as cultivation of mushrooms has been successfully applied to a variety of grain substrates, particularly grains which do not become soft when boiled, primarily cereal straws such as wheat straw, rice bran, millet straw, soybean straw, and brewer's grain. It appears then that the learned ability of cultivating mycology on wheat substrates, which were particularly abundant in ancient Egypt, can ultimately explain the integration of wheat images with the golden disc in place of the scarab motif with the golden disc. The reason that these mushrooms would have been so sacredly cultivated is because the psilocybin mushrooms contain a special kind of neurotropic hallucinogenic chemical called psilocybe. These mushrooms are famous for their golden or orange tops or caps. It has been well documented that these mushrooms are currently and traditionally used extensively by natives throughout regions of Mesoamerica during religious ritual and ceremony. These mushrooms are known to these native groups as little saints or flesh of the gods, and it is French mycologist Roger Heim who is credited for the discovery that psilocybe species is the neurotropic mushroom which has traditionally been used during spiritual practices, showing that these, quote, cow patty mushrooms, unquote, have in fact historically been used for ceremony, and therefore ancient Egyptians would not be an exclusive group to utilize this substance in ritual. To further explain the importance and sincerity of these substances in religious ceremony, it is important to note that, quote, the Mazatec do, moreover, sometimes suggest it is Christ who speaks to them during their hallucination, unquote. Therefore, it is possible that the attributed neurotic effects of psilocybe to induce spiritual or hallucinogenic experiences which are, quote, commonly known as ego death and spiritual rebirth, were apparently a central, though well-hidden element in many Egyptian religious rituals, unquote. Historically, elite classes using encrypted symbolism to maintain hidden messages is not new, and psychoactive substances such as psilocybin mushrooms are traditionally used by the priestly shamanic classes during religious ceremony and or ritualistic settings that are, more often than not, conducted covertly and with great secrecy. As illustrated on an Egyptian passage from the Book of the Dead, a funerary text reserved for the walls of royalty, which reads, quote, and you shall perform these ceremonies secretly. Let no stranger anywhere have knowledge of it. Do not speak about it to any man. Do not repeat it, unquote. The symbolism of the cattle as sacred has also become an extremely common motif within ancient Egyptian artwork. Motifs of the sacred cattle, usually depicted with the disc between its two horns, became a central theme throughout royal religious societies. It is commonly accepted that the bull was historically worshipped in ancient Egypt by groups known with names such as the cults of Menvis, Bucis, Apis, and others. Cattle were so highly ritualized in Egypt that they were culturally portrayed as royalty and even manifestations of deity. The cattle of Egypt, both males and females, typically have larger and more distinct elongated horns when compared to Western breeds. The cattle itself, as well as just the horns, can be found in royal Egyptian motifs in several forms, such as engravings, statues, and paintings, and are often depicted with a disc, typically golden, between its horns. The disc and horn symbol combination therefore appears to be related to the psilocybe-producing dung, which is utilized by the sacred beetle. The bull horns, as the two wheat stalks, seem to have become a simple replacement or interchangeable symbol for the beetle arms or wings, which traditionally flanked the golden disc. To exemplify this point that the horn and disc symbols are interchangeable with the beetle and disc motifs, we often see a scarab or bird figure underneath the horns. The bird then, commonly falcons or vultures, can easily be interchanged with the bird-like flying scarab motif as an encrypted substitute. Egyptian motifs are also depicted with the beetle blatantly holding the disc and horns simultaneously, presumably to enunciate the symbol combinations. To articulate the sacredness of cattle within the ancient Egyptian Empire, it ought to be considered that excavations of Egypt show entire temple structures built specifically for housing and diligently caring for sanctified cattle. The cattle were even depicted as the embodiment of Pharaoh. When the time came, these sacred cattle were bestowed funerary services fit for a king. A sacred cattle's funerary rites would include mummification entailing a heart scarab, treasured gifts, and burial within a sarcophagi, which was specifically made large enough to fit an entire mummified bull. One excavated necropolis of sacred bulls, known as the Serapium of Saqqara, is located near Cairo, Egypt, in a huge underground gallery which contained the massive sarcophagi of some 30 sacred mummified bulls. The large sarcophagi are carved from granite or limestone, and each is accompanied with inscriptions describing the periods in which the sacred bull had lived. The sacred bull's connection to the cow dung inhabiting scarab, and therefore psilocybe, was exemplified by a mark of the scarab encrypted onto the bull's tongue. When archaeologists originally attempted to decipher the importance of these different symbols in ancient Egypt, the themes were simply overlooked by researchers, many of which had little or no information regarding psilocybe. It was previously thought by Egyptologists that the entire ancient Egyptian civilization, including royalty, must have held a, quote, misunderstanding of the behavior and nest-building activities of some dung beetles, unquote, and that that misunderstanding was maintained throughout the entire history of ancient Egypt for over 3 millennia. Until recent times, it has thus been accepted that the pharaohs, which are attributed to massive monumental works such as pyramid structures, and whom are said to have been in charge of vastly stretching empires that reigned longer than any known civilization to date, quote, misunderstood the actual birth cycle of the beetle, and that they apparently thought of the beetle as being a single sex, male, which planted his seed in the round dung ball out of which came his offspring, unquote. The notions ascribed to the sacred scarab were thus that the dynasties reigning in Egypt were never aware of the activities of the female beetles. Previously, scholars have accepted these simple notions that ancient Egyptians, quote, very early associated the mistaken view of the dung beetle with the divine power they called Khepri, who was a form of the sun god Ra, the morning sun reborn by self-regeneration, unquote. Thus, it can be stated that the new evidence recently provided by Watson and others on sacred psilocybin mushroom use, in conglomeration with a plethora of other research, has given overwhelming support to this alternative theory, one which propounds that Egyptian artists were not, quote, misunderstanding, unquote, but instead were misunderstood, and that the motifs of the scarab pushing a sun disk is in fact not a depiction of an actual sun at all, but rather inferably the golden cap of a psilocybin mushroom.